Hello guys, and welcome back to a new video. Today I will make a very very important video for you guys. I know most of you wait this video for a long time, and finally today I get my time, I get the time to do it for you. And today we will talk about Tesla Model 3 long range all-wheel drive real life range. So today you will know how many kilometer you can drive with a full battery in the winter and in the summer. So I try to explain you from my experience. I think that the best advice you will get from the people that really own the car and drive every day with the car, and from those people you can get the best information and the real life information, and not from the short reviews and stuff like that. You have to own a few months the car in order to know those information in real. So I own the car now, I think almost 5 months. I have almost 10,000 kilometer. I drive in winter most of the time. In the last month was a little bit more warm outside, but the temperature was not over 30 degrees. So actually I will make another video in the summer, but because of you guys, because you asked me for this video, I will do it now, and I will do another one, another update on this video after the summer or in the summer, and I will tell you what is the real consumption. So first time guys, a few days ago I charged the car to 100%, because I want to show you how much it will tell me I still have on the Tesla screen. For example, right now guys, I have 93%, you can see right there. And if I go here to the display and I display 95% distance, and I have 464 kilometer in this moment. Let me make it a little bit brighter for you. So right now I have 464 kilometer. When I get the car first time when I take the car, it was 496 kilometer. You will see it on the screen. And after almost 10,000 kilometer, I charged the car fully, and I was expected that this number to be much lower, but it wasn't. The number was the same, so incredible. I charged the car to 100% and it showed me the same range, 496 kilometer. So I don't know if this make a difference, or maybe the battery range really lost just maybe 1%, or maybe something very small. I charge always the car to 90%. Only one time I charged 100% when I make this video a few days ago, and one time to 95%. And first time when I get the car, I get it with 100%. In rest, always to 90% or 80%, and I never drive lower than 10% with the battery. I try to keep it between 10% and 90%. There I heard it's better for the battery in long term, so I really take care of the battery. Also, most of the time I drive in chill mode, not so fast. Sometimes I test the car, I drive a little bit faster, but only maybe 5% of the time. In rest I drive always slowly and nice. So now the moment that you all waiting for, it's now. And before I tell you the real range, let me show you my consumption guys. So right now I just reset this meter. So in the last 7200 kilometer, the consumption it was 1120 kilowatt hour. This was the electricity consumption, and the average consumption, it was 156. This was the average consumption in the last 7,000 kilometer. So not bad at all for the consumption. Also, what I observe when I drive the last days, it was hot outside, around 20 degrees, and I observe that the car consume much less than this. If you drive in the city, not faster than 110 kilometer, the consumption, it's amazing. So you have to keep the car between 50 and 110 and drive, kind of anticipate how the traffic go and slowly accelerate, slowly decelerate when you brake, and you will have an amazing consumption. And I'm really happy with this car. I think Tesla make amazing battery and motors. I think they do a great job with the consumption. Another thing that I find out is, like, every day when you keep the car in the parking lot, because of the coronavirus and this problem, everybody's closed, we have to stay in home most of the time, or you are able to go jogging, for example, like this person here, or you can go walking on the mountains or stuff like that, but it's not allowed to stay much more person together. Actually, it's not recommended to stay together, because of this, the car was in the park place, and every day I lost like 1% from the battery. So keep this in mind. If you park the car, if you go on holiday, recommend it to charge it to 90%, and then the car every day will lost 1%. If it's very hot outside, the battery will try to cool down to keep a nice temperature, and when it's very cold, the battery, the system here under the car, will try to keep the car, the battery warmer. So that why it has to consume a little bit energy, because it's this amazing system that keep the battery in the perfect temperature, that in this way you will keep the battery for a longer time, it will last longer. So guys, let me tell you my experience. I drive every day to work like 50-60 kilometer every day, and I make an average consumption and I make calculation. I don't want to show you here, I don't want to make so long video, I just want to tell you short, you get the information and you keep it in mind. So in the winter time, my consumption, 0 to 100%, yes, after I calculate, it was, I'm able to drive this long range battery, all-wheel drive. If I'm not driving so fast, I'm normal drive, okay? Just normal. Sometimes fast, sometimes slow. City, highway, all together, mix. You are able in the winter to drive between 350 km and 400 km. Between this is the real range in the winter, with the heat on sometimes, the seat always on, but the heat not... Just sometimes you close it, sometimes you turn it on, sometimes you turn it off. So between 350 and 400 kilometer. In the summer, I find out in the last month that the temperature was over 5 degrees, between 5 and 50 degrees, and the consumption was better, and the battery, I didn't use the heating inside the car, only the seat heating sometimes, and I'm able to drive without any problem 400 kilometers. So my guess, it's in the summer you can drive between 450 and 500 kilometer if you not drive so fast. So if you drive like normal drive, mixed drive, hot, you can use climatic system and stuff like that, I think in the summer the consumption will be between 400 and 450. So my guess, it's that you can drive this car, the battery range, the real average of the battery and of the range is between 400 and 450. So that's just to keep in mind. So that was my impression and information until now. I will make another video in the summer to give you more updates about this consumption and how my battery it's running, but until now the battery, it's almost like new. Maybe it lost 1%, I'm not sure, but I don't think so. I don't feel nothing. I feel like in the first day The battery, it's and the system works still perfect, no problem at all. Pretty happy with the car. I totally recommend the Tesla cars. They are amazing. But anyway, guys, I hope it was helpful for you. If you like it, please share it with other people. Subscribe to my channel if you want to see more of those videos. I also have a lot of other videos with Tesla Model 3. You can check it out. Also, if you want to buy a Tesla, you can use my referral code. You will get 1,500 kilometer. And I will leave it here in the description and also in the video. Guys, I guess that was my video. Thank you for watching. Please subscribe to my channel and see you soon in the next one. Stay safe and stay home, guys.